Right now I'm going to show you a new feature in Lightroom or Camera Raw to get rid of color contamination from images. This would have been so difficult before, now it's easy. Alright, let's have a look at how the point color works. So what we're going to be doing is going under the color mixer, and you'll see the mixer, and here is the point color. Now this works the same in Lightroom as it does in Camera Raw, so you can use it in either. So the first thing we want to do is grab the eyedropper, and with the eyedropper we're going to select a color. Let's grab the green in this hedge, and we can see that's the selected color. Now we can move three different things: the hue, the saturation, and luminance. Hue is the color, so as I move this, we can change the color from greens to oranges. The second movement is saturation, or the amount of color. If I increase it, we get more green. If I decrease it, we get less, almost going into a grayscale. So the next one is luminosity, or brightness. So if we pull it to the left, it's going to darken those areas. Pull it to the right, it's going to brighten those areas. You can also adjust it in these swashes if you want to do it faster. So we can adjust the saturation up and down, or the hue side to side, or just drag it up to a color that you want to select. And the luminance is on this side here. Now here's a little trick. If you hold down the Alt or the Option key when you move these sliders, you'll see the areas that are in color are the areas that are going to be adjusted, and the areas in black and white are not going to be affected. Okay, so we want to refine this. So how would we go ahead and refining it? If we look underneath, there's another option called Range. If I pull the range all the way to the left, it's going to narrow the range that's going to be selected. If we hold the Visualize range, you can see. If I increase this, notice it will affect other areas, like you'll start to see it here in the background, behind there. If I decrease that range, see how those areas are not being affected. Now we have even more control. If we hit this little disclosure triangle, we have hue, saturation, and luminance. So we can make a selection based on these different things. So if we want to make a selection based on the hue, and we'll keep this visualized range on, we want to take it off the hair. We move this to the right. Notice as I drag that in, it's not affecting those tones as much. Same thing with saturation. We can adjust the saturation. So notice that's taking it off her cheek. And then we also have the luminance, so we can select based on this as well. Okay, let's turn that visualize range off now. And we've just selected this top part of the hedge. Now we can go ahead and we can make our adjustments. We can adjust our saturation, we can adjust our hue, and see how we can put this nice green into that hedge, and notice it's not affecting anything else in the image. This is the power of point color. All right, let's jump into our example. And if you're getting any value out of this video, hit that subscribe button, turn on notifications, you won't miss any of my videos. So if we look at this camera, notice that the reflective areas are picking up some pink here, it's picking up some blue. We've got color contamination coming from another light. Let's remove the contamination without affecting the colors of everything else. So we're going to go under the point color. And the first thing we're going to do is we're going to grab the eyedropper, and then we're going to go over the first color. So the main color I see is over here. We've got this kind of bluish, kind of going into purples. Let's just click to select it. Now when I tap, notice that we get, this is the color selected. So now what we want to do is we want to affect just this area. So we can refine this. So if you look at the range, we can adjust the amount of range. Now we don't really know what's being affected. If you want to see what's being affected, you can choose Visualize Range. And as we increase or reduce that, you can see where it's affecting. So that's definitely the range that we want to get in the image. So just the colored areas are going to be affected. And I can see those are where all the color contamination is. We can further refine this. If we pop this open, we can now work in hue, saturation, and luminance. So we can use all of these to help us refine this selection. By the way, if you don't want to visualize the range, you can literally just hold down the Alt or the Option key, and then when you move any of these sliders, it's going to do the same thing. But let's turn Visualize Range on. So let's have a look at the hue. If we turn this off for a second, we can see, yeah, there's definitely other areas we want to get here, this area here. So why don't we increase the amount of hue? So as we slide this out, notice it's going to start to also include the blues on this side, or these tones. As we go to the other side, it's going to start to affect some of those purpley tones. And notice as we do that, it increases the selected area. So we definitely want more hue there. That's good. And if there was areas that were being picked up that we didn't, we could pull these sliders to adjust them, but I think we're fine. Let's look at the saturation. So this is the highly saturated area definitely being picked up, and that's a problem in the image. But let's reduce the saturation to include some other areas. And let's do luminance. So right there's the brighter areas. If we go to the left, it selects the darker areas. So let's increase this and see if we can get most of what we want. All right, it's picking up in this area now. Okay, let's turn the visualize range off. What we want to do now is we just want to reduce the saturation. So we're just going to take saturation shift, and as we pull that down, notice it removes the color cast from those blues. And so far, we've got rid of that color cast. If we look at it before and after, look at the shadow underneath here. Now it's gone, looking a lot better. Now there's still a little bit of pinkish kind of tone in here, so why don't we do the same thing? The nice thing about this is we have the ability to click again and we can select a second color. So let's select the salmon color. And we'll just try the saturation. If we pull that down, we're pretty close. Now let's play around with the hue. See if we can pick up some more of that. Notice as we increase it, it gets more. All right, so this is definitely helping. So there we are, before and after. And why don't we do a third one? So let's select again. Let's grab this pinkish tone in there. And I think I can just hit the saturation and remove that. Look at that. As we do, notice it removes the saturation of those colors around there, but leaves the reds. Look at that. All the reds are still there. And so if we look at this before and after, notice we got rid of all that color contamination without affecting the rest of the colors in the image. So I'm curious if you like this new feature. Let me know in the comments underneath. And if you want to know more of the new features in Lightroom, check out this video here. If you're new, welcome to the cafe. Hit the subscribe button, turn on notifications, and until next time, I'll see you at the cafe.